class 9. Today we are going to start with the revision of the chapter Adventures of Toto. So first of all, what this chapter is about? This chapter is about Toto. Who is Toto? Toto is a monkey. Okay, and what kind of monkey? He was quite mischievous in nature and he was causing a lot of damage to the house as well as to the various daily activities and that were being carried forward in the house. So this chapter, of course, it is a humorous account. What this chapter is? This chapter is a humorous account of the various nuisances created by the animal. Okay. So first of all, we will, you can say, revise about the background from where the grandfather has bought. So from where the grandfather has bought this monkey, he has from a Tonga driver. For how much amount? For 5 rupees he has got. Okay. So he has bought. Why he has bought that? He was tied to a feeding trough and it was seen almost, you can say, out of place. So the grandfather thought that he should purchase this animal because it was completely out of its place, and he wanted to add an animal to his private zoo. Okay, to add an animal in the collection of his private zoo. Okay, so this is the reason why he has purchased this monkey. So if we talk about the looks of monkey, what kind of? He was bright eyes, okay, sparkling bright eyes, which were set under the eyebrows, okay, having a wide grin, frightening any Anglo-Indian lady, okay, then always showing a grin. What is the meaning of grin? 1 minute. What is the meaning of grin? It's a smile showing the teeth, okay, grin means smile showing the teeth, okay, but his, yes. That I have told, that sparkling eyes set under the eyebrows. Okay, then afterwards he also has, you can say, wide grin, wide smile, and the hands were so dried up as if they were pickled up in the sun. Okay, this is a comparison made here. Okay, and simile is used here, right? So after that, what he has told, that he has also, you can say, very quick, okay, very quick fingers, right? So the fingers were so quick and the tail was adding to its beauty. So how the tail was adding to its beauty? The tail was looking? The tail was actually acting as a third hand. Okay, wherever his hand could not reach, he could scoop out anything with the help of his tail. So tail was actually, you can say, acting as an assistance. Okay, assistance for taking anything out from the place. Okay, so these are the looks of the monkey. So grandfather, first of all, when this monkey was brought to home, his presence in the house, it was not disclosed to grandmother. Why the presence was not disclosed to grandmother? Because she always fussed about the presence of any, you can say, new animal in the house. It was difficult for her to manage any animal in the house. So first of all, when this monkey was purchased from the Tonga driver, his presence in the house was kept a secret. And later on, what was decided, that when the grandmother would be in a good mood, the presence of the monkey would be disclosed to her. Okay. So after a few hours, when this monkey was purchased and it was brought home, where it was kept? Where it was kept? In a little closet, okay, where he was fastened. What is the meaning of fastened means? Tied. He was fastened to a peg which was attached inside the closet, okay. But this monkey was quite mischievous in nature. What he has done? He has ripped off, taken off all the wallpaper, okay, ornamental paper, that is a wallpaper that was attached to the wall. And ultimately, the brick and the plaster was also ripped off and the bricks were turned nailed. The bricks were visible. Okay. And the quote of the narrator. Who is the narrator here in this chapter? Who is the little boy? Ruskin Bond. Okay. Ruskin Bond is the little boy here who is sharing his experiences. Right. So, the coat which was you can say which was you can say which was you can say put on one of the you can say one wall. It was you can say how it was. It was completely torn into shreds by the monkey. The monkey has completely torn into shreds. Okay, but this did not make the grandfather annoyed with her with the behavior of the monkey. But what he was thinking, he was actually fascinated. Okay, by this kind of intelligence of the monkey, he thought that if they would have given some more time, the monkey would have made a rope out of these shreds and would have climbed out of the window of the house. Okay, so this is one of the you can say first mischievous act that was done by the monkey whose name was Toto. But his presence in the house was still a secret. Okay, it was finally. When it has caused a lot of damage in the room, finally where it was transferred into a cage. Okay, where this cage was placed, the cage was placed in servants' quarters. Servants' quarters, where in servants' quarters, number of other animals were also living there who were tamed by the grandfather. Who were the other animals who were living there? Tortoise, pair of rabbits, tame squirrel as well as pet goat. Okay, so but what kind of this animal monkey was, he was not allowing other animals to take any kind of rest or to take rest. So finally one day what happened, that grandfather has to go to Saharanpur. Why he has to go to Saharanpur? In order to collect his pension. So for some of the reason or one or the other reason, the narrator was not able to accompany the grandfather, but later on he has narrated the complete incident to him. So what happened? In order to take this monkey along with him, what the grandfather had done, he has arranged a canvas bag. Canvas bag, okay, whose you can say whose material was so thick that the monkey could not bite it and would not make a hole in it. But what happened? So finally what happened? That at the base of this canvas bag, some straw was provided, which acted as a new place or new abode for this monkey. And it was monkey was put in it, and finally it was tied from the top so that every attempt of the monkey to come out of this bag, it would fail. So they have gone to the turnstile. When the grandfather, he was about to produced his ticket to show the ticket collector. So then what happened? The monkey, out of nowhere he has come out. Okay, from nowhere he has come out. He has poked his head out of the canvas bag and was trying to give a wide grin, wide smile to the ticket collector. The ticket collector was surprised to see the presence of an animal in the train compartment. So he, after long, you can say, discussion, he classified it as quadruped. Okay, quadruped means animal having four legs. Okay, but the grandfather was trying to make it, or he was trying to persuade him that he was not at all a monkey, and he was trying his every possible way to make, not to classify him as quadruped or an animal like that of dog who is having four legs. Finally, well, after long, you can say, negotiations, and afterwards what happened? That he has to purchase a ticket of sum of rupees 3. He has to purchase a ticket for the sum of rupees 3. And finally, what happened? The grandfather has taken out a tortoise out of his pocket. And when this pocket, it was presented to the ticket collector, what he did? He prodded it. What is the meaning of prod? Prod means to extend the finger and touch with it. Okay. He prodded it with his finger in order to check whether it was alive or not. And finally, the grandfather asked the ticket collector that whether you are going to charge for this animal also. And to this, the ticket collector replied that charges are not, you can say, applicable for all animals. Okay. So finally, because he said that it was not a dog. So finally, this was the incident at Saharanpur. Okay. So got clear? Okay. Everything is clear. So then afterwards, Toto. Toto was finally the grandmother. She came to know the presence of monkey in the house. Okay. Now he was placed in the open area where their in the stable where their donkey Nana. Okay, Nana was placed. But this monkey, he was always teasing Nana in each and every possible way. He was not at all trying, or he was not at all letting this monkey, donkey to take any kind of rest. So one day what has happened, there were some noises from the stable, and when the grandfather has gone there, so what he has noticed? Yes. Toto was pulling the tail of the Nana and was not allowing to eat the hay or the straw which was placed in front of him. So what happened? Grandfather came and gave a slap to Nana, and he was dragging the monkey away. Okay. So in this manner, finally, it was also separated from the rest of the animals because he was not letting any other animal to take rest. So he was mischievous in nature. He was not allowing the family members to take rest. He was not at all allowing the other animals in the house to take rest. Okay. So after that, he was fastened. Okay. He was fastened onto one side separately. And later on, after that, what were the daily habits of this monkey? Okay. So how he was taking bath? Who will explain how he was taking bath? Yes.
So he used to connect it, test the temperature with his hands, and then gradually steps into the bath.
Hmm.
First in his bath and then the other.
Hmm.
Until he was into the water up to his neck.
Hmm.
Once something, he would take the soap in his hands, and then
pretend like the. Okay, right. So what he would do, first of all, he would touch the temperature of the water, test the temperature of the water with his hands. From where he has learned this? He has learned this from the narrator. Okay, after sitting in the hot water. Yes. Okay, because the name of the monkey was Toto. So obviously, Nana was the donkey. Okay, so finally, when he would be comfortable enough in the hot water, then what he would do? He would sit in the tub and would apply soap all over the body. Then after sitting for a while inside this, when he felt cold, he would came out of the water and he would run near the kitchen fire. Okay, why? In order to dry up his body. Okay, dry himself up. So, and if anybody would laugh at these kind of acts, what he would do? He would feel like that his feelings are being hurt, and the next time he would never be going for a bath. So one more incident has been added up to this story, that one day the monkey, he has almost burned himself up. How he has burned himself up? Almost he has burned himself up. Yes. The grandmother has placed a water kettle, okay, for boiling water for some other purposes, for tea and some other purposes, onto the gas stove. So what happened? Toto thought that this sit properly. Toto thought that it has been placed for his bathing. So what happened? Toto jumped and sat into the kettle. So first of all, he felt that the water was quite warm. But later on, what has happened? That he felt the water hot inside. Okay, it started boiling. So he stood up and to come out of the kettle. But outside, what he felt? He felt it very cold outside. So what happened? He again sat into the kettle. But soon what happened? The water started boiling. Okay, as the water started boiling, he started shrieking, he started screaming. And the grandmother had come, and she could recognize that what mischievous act he has done. And finally what happened? She has taken it out of the kettle, almost in his half-boiled condition. Okay, so the narrator is saying that this monkey was quite mischievous in nature. If one would think of the special part of the brain which was specially developed in this monkey, that was just his, you can say, that mischievous part of the brain, or the part of the brain which was specially related to the mischievous acts, that was specially developed in this monkey. So after that, another naughty habit of this monkey was again added. So one day what happened during lunchtime? Pulao was cooked and it was placed in a tray. or in a big tray at the dining table. So the grandmother was calling everyone to have lunch. But what happened? When they came around, they have seen that the monkey was sitting on the dining table and he was stuffing his mouth with these rice, okay, with the rice or with pulao. The grandmother, she shouted at the monkey. But what happened? He threw a plate at the grandmother and it was broken into pieces. So later on, what has happened? Yes, and when one of the aunts came and started shrieking, then what happened? The monkey, he has taken the entire plate along with himself and has settled up at one of the branches of the jackfruit tree. Okay, he has sat over the jackfruit tree. Then what happened? He was stuffing every leftover grain of the rice, and ultimately there was nothing left for the entire family to eat anything. And after eating, he has thrown that costly tray onto the ground and it was again broken into number of pieces. Okay, so this is how he has caused another damage in the house. So finally, grandfather, he has also realized this, that this monkey is not to be placed in the house as it is causing a lot of damage. Because it was causing a lot of damage, so he thought that this monkey should be returned back to the Tonga driver. For how much money he has purchased? 3 rupees. And finally, for how much he has sold it back? 5 rupees, and sold it for rupees 3. Okay, so finally, it was sold back to the Tonga driver. Okay, because he thought that the amount of destruction and amount of damage caused by this monkey to the curtains, to the houseware, to the all the things in the house, if they are not able to bear up this kind of loss, because it was so mischievous. So finally it was returned back to the Tonga driver. Okay, so why the monkey was returned back to the Tonga driver? Because it was causing a lot of destruction in the house. Yes, Pragun, what kind of destruction was caused by the monkey in the house? And he has torn all the curtains of the house. Okay, so one day the monkey was trying to boil himself up. How? Started boiling, then what happened? So he was feeling very hot inside the kettle, and when the water started boiling, it was almost half boiled. And when the grandmother, she came and saved the monkey from being boiled up. Okay, yes, Vatsal, why the presence of monkey in the house was kept a secret? Why the presence of monkey in the house was kept a secret? Why the presence of monkey in the house was kept a secret? And yes, but why he was mischievous, they later on came to know. But why they kept it as a secret? 1 minute, let me ask. Yes, Simon, sit down, please. I asked why the presence of monkey was kept a secret. Yes.
Because grandmother was always fussing about the new animal.
Yes, because the grandmother was always fussing about the presence of any new animal in the house. Okay. So how was Toto a nuisance for the other animals in the private zoo of the grandfather? Okay, Gurjab. Okay, who will explain it in detail? Panika? Yes. Right. Because he is always a nuisance for other animals. So sit down, please. So first of all, when this monkey was brought into the house and it was kept in a private zoo along with other animals, where pet goat, tame squirrel, pair of rabbits, okay, were living in harmony with each other. Okay, he was not at all allowing those animals to take sleep. Okay, so finally it was separated in the stable along with the donkey named Nana. And to Nana, what he has done, that he was not allowing. One day he was pulling his tail, not allowing to eat even a straw from the hay which was placed in front of him. And ultimately he was forced into one of the ear. And ultimately what happened? The grandfather came and gave a slap. Okay, and this is how he was doing. Okay, so how can you say that Toto was mischievous monkey? How he was mischievous monkey? So what are the different things, different acts of his mischievousness? Yes, first of all, the first thing was that when he was brought. So first of all, when he was brought to the house, then what first thing that he has done? He was put in Almira. And then what he has done? Okay, scratch the wallpaper. Okay, scratch the wallpaper and yes, and remove the plaster off the bricks, and it was turned out to be naked. And moreover, he has also torn the blazer, okay, or the coat of the narrator, which was hung inside into shreds. Okay, coat into shreds. Okay, you should know each and every detail. Okay, then this is first thing. Then not allowing. Yes, not allowing animals to take or to sleep. Then afterwards. Okay, noises and biting them. Then afterwards, boiling incidents. Okay, then Pulao incident also. Okay. Okay. Whenever, yes, her aunt used to come house, what he would do? He would poke a hole into her new dress and causing much harm to her dress. Okay, so these are the various incidents which we can relate that he was quite mischievous in nature. So how Toto was taken to Saharanpur? Yes, second last boy. Stand up. Your name? Vaibhav, huh? Vaibhav. How Toto was taken to Saharanpur? Sit down. In a bag, then wow. How? Give detail. Actually, it was a bag. It was a canvas bag. Okay, it was a canvas bag in which he was taken. Sit down next. Elaborate it. Yes. Sit down. Next, last. I think so. This is fourth time this chapter I am revising. Still blank. Yes. It was a big canvas bag that was provided to take the monkey to Saharanpur. Very good. Yes, it turned out to be a new abode for the monkey. And at the base of this canvas bag, what was placed? Straw. Straw was placed. And it was tied. Sit down, please. And it was tied tightly at the top so that he could not make his escape out of it. Okay, out of it. Okay. What was the experience of the grandfather when he brought Toto for the first time or for the very first day to his house? So what was the experience of the grandfather?
He described Toto as clever. He was pleased with Toto's performance.
He was, yes, good. Okay, so mischievous, of course he was. Okay, but he was, first of all, he was?
Yes.
He thought it to be clever enough, because otherwise if he would have given any chance, what he would have done? He would have he would have made a rope out of the shreds of the coat and would have escaped through the window. And what other? He was pleased with his performance. He was not irritated. Okay? He was not at all irritated at that time, but he was enjoying his performance. He was fascinated by the intelligence of this small animal. Okay? So this is the grandfather's experience when he has brought the monkey to his house for the first time. What did Toto do with the pulao kept on the dining table? Pulao incident. Yes. Right. He started stuffing his mouth when the grandmother came and started screaming at her, shouting at him. He has thrown a plate at her. Okay. Then when the aunt came, what he did? He has taken the entire tray and has climbed over the jackfruit tree. Okay, and sat in one of the branches of the jackfruit tree where he has stuffed every grain of the pulao into his mouth. And finally, what he has done, he has thrown it onto the ground. Okay, right? And he has thrown it onto the ground. Right? And what has happened? It was? Yes, it was broken down into hundreds of pieces. So I think that with this, the revision is complete of this chapter. Any doubt? Okay. So that's all for today. In the next class, we will do the next chapter. Okay.